Hi, welcome back to the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you 15 little-known type keyboard shortcuts. These shortcuts will allow you to work faster and better with text. Let me know in the comments how many of these shortcuts are new to you, and if you see at least one that you find useful, then click on that like button. And of course, don't forget to subscribe and to click on that notification button. Okay, let's get started. I'm going to select the type tool, and with this first keyboard shortcut, I'm going to show you how you can rotate, scale, and move a new text layer. Let me show you what I mean. When you click with the type tool in Photoshop CC, you'll get dummy text, and you can, of course, type whatever you like. For example, the word text and the word layer. And if I want to move, rotate, or scale that layer, you can hold the control key. That's the command key on the Mac, and you'll get access to the transformation handles. So you can click and drag to transform it and scale it up. I can click and drag it to move it, and I can hover just outside of the bounding boxes until I get the double-sided arrow and click and drag to rotate. And this is still editable text. Did you know that you can fill with the foreground and background color on a text layer? Let me show you what I mean by that. With the text selected, you can press Alt and Backspace, that's Option Delete on the Mac, to fill with the foreground color. If you just have the entire text layer selected without selecting a specific part of the text, and then you use the same keyboard shortcut, Alt and Backspace, Option Backspace on the Mac, it fills the entire layer. To fill with the background color, you can press Control Backspace, that's Command Backspace on the Mac. If you want to create a new text layer near another text layer, sometimes when you click, you might accidentally activate the previous text layer. So you would have to click away, far away, and then move this text layer onto the space that you want to put it in. However, what you can do is use this keyboard shortcut when creating the new layer. So I'm going to select the type tool, then I'm going to hover over directly this area and hold the shift key. If I hold the shift key and click, I create the new text layer near the previous text layer and it doesn't activate. Notice what happens if I click on the same area and not hold the shift key. It activates the previous text layers. So remember, hold the shift key if you want to create a new text layer near a previous text layer without activating it. To change the size of your text, simply select the text that you want to adjust, then hold Ctrl, Shift, and the greater than key to make the text larger. That's the same key as the period, or the less than key, that's the same key as the comma to make text smaller, and you can see how that adjusts the text size. You can quickly make the text in your layer all caps or underline by using a keyboard shortcut. And you can do so by selecting your text and pressing Ctrl Shift K, that's Command Shift K on the Mac, to turn your letters into capital letters. And to underline, you can select the text and press Ctrl Shift U, that's Command Shift U on the Mac, to underline. To quickly make your text bold or italics, you can highlight the text and then press Ctrl Shift B. That's Command-Shift-B on the Mac for bold. Notice that the bold font weight was added. If your font does not have a bold weight, what will happen instead is Photoshop will add a faux bold to your text. So keep that in mind. And for italics, you can press Control-Shift-I. That's Command-Shift-I on the Mac. And the same thing will happen if your font does not have the italic weight. You will add a faux italic. This next keyboard shortcut is one that not a lot of people know, but I use it all the time and I think that it's worth remembering since it can be very useful. In the characters panel, you'll notice that I have enabled all these formatting options. To quickly reset them all to default, you can double click on the text layer thumbnail to select the text and then press Ctrl Shift Y, that's Command Shift Y on the Mac. Notice how now all these buttons are disabled, and I can continue working with the text with the default formatting. And by the way, if you're enjoying this tutorial, then you might also enjoy some of my other Photoshop text tutorials. I have a playlist on YouTube where I keep all my text tutorials. Tutorials such as the Black Panther text effect, some 3D text effects, and even some beginner tutorials such as how to type in a circle in Photoshop and how to place text behind anything. I'll place a link to this playlist right below in the description. Now I'm going to show you three really important keyboard shortcuts. They will allow you to change the leading, kerning, and tracking. And so that you can see what I'm doing, I'm going to enable the characters panel under Window. I'm going to enable the text, and I'm first going to show you how to adjust the leading, thus the spacing in between the lines. So you can select text, and if you hold Alt, that's Option on the Mac, and use the down arrow key, you can move the text down. Notice the values here in the character panel. And I can tap on the up arrow key while holding Alt to move the text back up. And if you add the Shift key to that, you can change the baseline shift, which moves the selected characters up or down relative to the baseline of the text. So I'm holding Alt, Shift, and tapping on the up arrow key. To move the text below the baseline, tap the down arrow key. See that? And you can see the numerical values in this text box. So you don't have to remember the keyboard shortcuts. You can use this dialog box if you like, but you can do things much faster if you remember the keyboard shortcuts. And to change the kerning, click in between two characters, then hold Alt and the left arrow key or the right arrow key, and this changes the space in between two characters. And you can see how this text box is changing as I make those adjustments with the keyboard shortcut. If you're working with paragraphs and you want to disable the hyphenation, these hyphens, you can enable the text, press Control A, Command A on the Mac to select all the text, and then press Control Alt Shift H, that's Command Option Shift H on the Mac, to toggle the paragraph hyphenation. And I can bring the hyphens back by using the same keyboard shortcut. And this is not going to be a technique that uses a keyboard shortcut, but I still think that it's valuable and you can consider it a bonus. If you want to reposition an active text layer without exiting the editing mode, then you can hover just outside of the text into the cursor changes into the move tool icon. Then you can click and drag to move it and release after you reposition it. Once again, hover over just outside of the bounding box. You'll see the cursor change, then click and drag and release. And again, if you found any of these keyboard shortcuts useful, then click on that like button now and let me know down in the comments below how many of them you knew already. If this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, then don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you again in the next tutorial.